This week's show is sponsored by Celebrate Vitamins, providing the optimum level of vitamin and mineral supplementation that's tasty and affordable. Get all of your favorite Celebrate products at CelebrateVitamins.com. This week's episode of Bariatric TV is sponsored by Bariatric Advantage, the most complete line of micronutrient replacements specifically designed for the weight loss surgery patient. Help support the show by ordering your Bariatric Advantage products directly from the BTV eStore.
Hiya freaks, I'm Tony.
And I'm Linda, and this is BTV.
What do we have for you viewers this week?
In the drop zone, we have one of our longtime favorite freaks.
We take a look at some behind-the-scenes flub-ups from Houston.
Does weight loss surgery cure your food addiction? Inquiring minds want to know.
And some weight loss surgery-friendly cupcakes. My tongue got in my own way.
This week's Drop Zone Freak has been a friend of the show since darn near day one. Darn near?
He's also one of our most prolific forum posters who's always first in line with an answer.
Yep, this week's DZF is Ian, or Baca. He says he's glad he had surgery because I get to be a father and see my son grow up.
Now that's an excellent reason if I ever heard one.
So what are you waiting for? Send us your before and afters as well as one sentence on why you're glad you had weight loss surgery. Just email it to us at feedback@bariatrictv.com.
Because we'll bribe you with tasty soy chips.
Tasty revival chippy chips.
And now it's time for the dumping ground.
I don't feel good.
Hey gang, welcome to the dumping ground.
So, we've been at this bariatric TV thing now for over 2 years.
Yeah, you would think we would have a handle on all of it and never make mistakes.
Especially when we're out in public, right?
Yeah, not so much with that. Case in point, the recent ObesityHelp.com convention in Houston, Texas.
I'm almost positive that we used 10 times the amount of tape that we should have used, just on screw-ups.
And since we had to pay for the tape, Mike is insisting that we use all the footage, including the screw-ups.
Thanks, Mike.
So, just to prove what big dorks we are, enjoy!
Ha!
Ha! My name is Ha! My name's Ha! My
name is
Slim Shady!
Hi, this is Linda with bariatrictv.com. I'm here at the Obesity Help Conference.
Conference with Connie.
And if you make a mistake, that's great because our show, we always put the mistakes in. We leave them.
And then you can say, we flew to Houston, Texas, especially for you. And
boy, are our arms tired. Ho, ho, ho.
Mind, body, health services. Oh, sorry.
That's okay. Touch me. Touch me. I want to be there.
Okay. That was awesome.
Thank you. I like clapping.
All right. Well, thank you so much. Wait. First off, wait.
Psychotherapist. Intimacy, sex.
Sex, relationship. Just put that on there.
Unlike the States, most of our patients...
Well, it's nice to see that you brought your own baby.
So for those of you that don't know, Dr. Alvarez travels with his own band, which just showed up for us.
All right, well, I want to thank you guys for taking a moment with us. Thank you. Wave, everybody wave.
I have to watch those with my hands over my eyes. It's so embarrassing.
Yeah, I hear you. But we are who we are.
Time to end this madness and alter your reality.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Sally.
Sally who?
Sally, break good times, come on.
Celebrate that WLS cured your food addiction.
I don't think so, but nice try. Last time I checked, that addiction was still there. So what brought this topic up anyways?
Well, it came up on the boards over at Obesity Help recently. A gal by the name of Jennifer Joyner posted on the RNY forum that gastric bypass cured her of her food addiction.
Wow, that's just, wait. How far out is she from surgery?
Oh, about 2.5 years.
You know, come to think of it, I thought my food addiction was cured at about 2 years out, too.
Yeah, me too. I can remember feeling so free because I didn't ever have cravings for those old trigger foods.
Yeah, but at 7 years out, they're back. And I can eat more now than I could at 2 years.
Luckily, I do still dump, so I got that going for me.
I hear you, sister. It was interesting to read all the responses to Jennifer's post on OH. Some were newer post-ops and pre-ops that were hopeful surgery would cure them, too.
And the old-timers like us, we know better. And a lot of them were very vocal in letting Jennifer know.
I'm sure they were.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. If you freaks read this, or if you've visited Jennifer's blog or website, just be aware. Gastric bypass is not a cure for what ails you. It helps to get control of the demons, but it won't get rid of them. They'll still be there lurking around, waiting to get you. You need an exorcist for that. Be gone, food demons! Be gone!
Out, demons, out!
It's not a magic bullet.
That was a Three Stooges move.
I know.
It's not a magic bullet. All surgery can do is help you lose the excess weight, if you follow the rules.
You, and only you, can ensure that you're a success by changing your habits. And that's something surgery can't do for you.
I know for some of you this sounds a bit ridiculous, but trust me, when you get further out, you'll understand. We're telling you this now, so hopefully it won't come as a big surprise. Do your research and listen to the people who have been there and done that.
At BTV, we just want to make sure that you freaks are as informed and prepared as you can be as you freak on. Cupcakes. I want cupcakes.
Who doesn't want cupcakes?
But they put you in a coma. They put me in a coma. Oh, sugar.
But I love cupcakes, and they're the perfect size for us freaks.
If only there was some way to have a sugar-free, yummy, decadent cupcake.
But wait, there is!
Well, T2 Nashville posted a recipe on our forums that came from Tasty Kitchen. I gave it a whirl, and I think I'm in heaven. Heaven.
I'm in heaven. Cause these cupcakes are so tasty and sugar free.
Okay.
Ooh, share.
It's a super simple recipe. You'll need one box of Pillsbury sugar free Devil's Food cake mix, a little box of Jell-O sugar free cheesecake pudding, 3 eggs, 2 cups of sour cream. I already have them measured out. You can use fat-free if you want. 1/3 cup of vegetable oil and 1/2 cup of water. Pretty much all you do is just dump all that into there and mix it with that. So here we go. Oh, look, there's a recipe on the back for mini whoopie pies. Nice. Whoopie pies, sugar-free cheesecake Jell-O mix. What next? Let's get rid of the oil before I spill it. It has happened. Hard to believe, I know, but I can be a klutz. I know you're shocked, aren't you? The water, the eggs, 3 of them. 1, 2, 3. Just in case you didn't believe me. The sour cream. This is gonna be fun to get out. Ooh, yummy. Okay, and then you just mix it all up. Hopefully it doesn't come flying out of this bowl. Hit me in the face. I've done that before too. You don't want to be around me when I cook.
You are riding the ragged edge of disaster, girl.
All right. Ah! Dang it. Get off. There we go. All right. Once it's all mixed, then you just scoop it into cupcake tins with liners. I just got the disposable ones because, you know, that's how I am. And I'm going to use an ice cream scoop. So they're they're all the same size. All right, so while you're scooping these into your little cupcake pans here, you should be preheating your oven to 350. Then you're just gonna slide these into the oven and bake them for about 15 minutes. Once they come out of the oven, you wait for them to cool, and then you can ice them. Pillsbury makes a good sugar-free icing you can use, or you can use some cream cheese, some sugar-free Cool Whip with Splenda, or you can eat them as they are. I kinda like them just the way they are. Cupcakes for everyone. Here, have one.
What do you think, Tony?
Oh my god. I'm just gonna make this work.
And they have it all on the moist side?
Mm-hmm. This is so good.
Smile for me. You look like one of them hillbilly family kids that's been drinking too much Mountain Dew.
It really is good. No kidding. All kidding aside, this is almost better than a regular cupcake.
I like these better than regular cupcakes, to tell you the truth.
Do you?
Uh-huh. I like because they're really moist.
Okay, freaks, that's it for this week. But before you go, we want to remind you to email us those before and after or before and during images to feedback@bariatrictv.com and include a one-sentence reason why you're glad you had surgery. We'll highlight you on the show and send you some tasty soy chips.
And please swing on by the store at btvstore.com to pick up some bariatric-friendly goods. It's the best way to support our show and our sponsors.
See you next week, you freaks.
I'm not a dork. I'm not a dork.
Yes, you are. You're a big dork.
Embrace your dorkness.
Uh-huh.
Case in point, the recent ObesityHelp.com convention.
What are you doing, Tony Town?
Embracing my dork.
I'm all freaked out.
Help support Bariatric TV by ordering your bariatric products from BTVStore.com. Use the coupon code FREAK and get a 10% discount on your next order.